The House That Jack Built is the newest film directed by Lars von Trier that showed in its unrated, uncut form last night for one night only. I saw it. This is the version that played at the Cannes Film Festival that received a lot of booing and walkouts and scathing reviews and very praiseworthy reviews, but that's per usual with von Trier. This film follows Matt Dillon as a serial killer named Jack on a 12-year killing spree. The film is broken up into a series of vignettes that are referred to as incidents, and usually in these incidents, someone dies, and we see these various scenarios play out from the perspective of Jack, who is also talking in his mind to someone he calls Verge. It's an older man, you can tell by the voice, and they're having a conversation about life, death, art, murder, and the state of the world. And so, it's a Lars von Trier movie, and a very gruesome one, as many people have talked about. It was widely publicized that the violence depicted in the film was hard to take for a lot of film festival audiences, and so IFC Midnight is doing a one-night-only uncut release, as well as a rated R release in the middle of December. Whenever I sit down and watch a Lars von Trier movie, I'm a combination of excited and worried. I drove to the nearest theater that was showing this in the ice and sleet last night, and I said to myself, von Trier, just give me a real movie, please. I'm out here driving through this ice in the 20-degree weather. Just give me a real movie. And at times he did. There are aspects of this movie that I thought were absolutely brilliant. The first 30 to 40 minutes of it, I loved it. Like, I was thinking in my head, this is one of the best films I've seen so far this year. It was darkly hilarious, sadistically brutal, but really, really funny. And I adored what I was seeing. I loved how Matt Dillon's Jack, he's so OCD and compulsive. There's this great sequence where he kills somebody. And then he goes out to his van, and he keeps imagining in his head that underneath the rug or underneath a chair or the lamp or the photo on the wall, there's got to be stains there, and he must go back and clean it. Even though we can hear police sirens coming, his obsessiveness, he just has to go back and clean it, and it was absolutely hilarious. There were so many scenes like that throughout the first act, and some towards the second and third, that I adored. I loved it. I loved the direction von Trier was taking, and I was thinking to myself, this is his best movie in years. And as per usual with von Trier, he's got to put things in the film that are shocking and grotesque, and he has to be very self-aggrandizing about his position and a little bit self-serving, and he kind of ruins his own movie at key points. This is going to be something that I'm sure will be very talked about and something that'll be subversive for a lot of film lovers. For myself, I'm not necessarily bothered by grotesque or brutal violence in a film if it has meaning and if it's there for a reason. Lars von Trier and his films, it's very hard sometimes to fully grasp exactly which one of those he's going for, because his movies all get people to talk and his films market themselves just based off of bad news surrounding them. I mean, look at what happened with Cannes. What movie got talked about more at that festival? It was his film, because people screamed about it and they walked out and said it was repulsive and misogynistic and all of these quotes. And then IFC Midnight did the unrated release and the MPAA said, hey, you guys broke our rules and you might be imposed by sanctions because of it. And that's just more press for it. And that's exactly what I think he would like, which is what I don't like. I just wish that von Trier cared more about making a great film than getting reactions from people. There are aspects of this film, as I said, that I loved. Matt Dillon gives the best performance of his entire career, I think, possibly. He is so, so good in this movie, and it's worth seeing for his performance. If I were to, say, negatively review this film, which, strangely, I don't really want to do. I don't want to say, don't see this movie. I mean, there's certainly things in it in regards to violence against children and animals that's highly disgusting and very bleak, and in some cases a bit unnecessary in regards to its depiction, but it does have a meaning in the movie, and it does have a place in the movie, and so I can, in a way, defend it. The film absolutely has a message about the state of violence and the state of our world in regards to von Trier's perspective of it, and the fact that sometimes people just don't want to help when they could help. And so I understand what he's trying to communicate. So if I were to say, don't see this movie, or that I didn't enjoy aspects of this movie, it's not because of a very misogynistic misogynistic speech he gives, it's not because of violence against children or animals. It's because of what he does that he does in all of his movies lately. Later in the film, he decides to have a full dissertation on art in modern history and icons of modern history, and he shows clips from his past films, Antichrist and Melancholia, and he talks about the great art that has shaped us while showing clips from his movies. If you pay attention to the credits of the film, he has credited himself with some outlandish and absurd things. I mean, he puts himself in his movies' posters. He absolutely has a gigantic ego, which doesn't necessarily make sense, because he refers to himself as someone with a ton of phobias, socially, a ton of concerns, someone who has dealt with so much depression that he almost quit, and yet he makes movies where his head is so gigantic, it's threatening to explode, and I just don't really understand that. I can understand a filmmaker who wants to share their passion and their vision with others and say, please understand how I feel. This is how I feel, and this is my art. Please understand me. But the way von Trier makes his art doesn't really feel like sharing. It feels like shoving, even to his own fans. There was a woman sitting in front of me at the screening. There was a message from von Trier before the movie started, and he said a few jokes, and she laughed, and she said out loud, I love him. Halfway through the movie, she was groaning and she was grunting, and she started to walk to the bathroom a lot and kind of exit for a long period of time and then come back for a while. When even his fans feel accosted by his films, that's a dangerous place to be in. It's also a very exciting place to be in, which is why I have such a hard time reviewing this movie and why I'm sure a lot of other film critics and film lovers will also have a tough time deciding how they feel, because there are parts of this movie that are so impactful and so, I think, important to see that I can see the film in the future being regarded as something that was a bit game-changing, similar to how Alfred Hitchcock made Psycho. It was very violent and very disturbing, very graphic. Peeping Tom, for instance, both in 1960, strangely. Both of those films, very impactful, very important for the horror scene. This film, though, the question is, is the violence there for a reason? Does it mean something to the story, or is it von Trier saying, hey, let's see if I can push the envelope from what other people have done? Which to me, that doesn't require very much talent. Anybody can think of a depraved idea and put it in their movie and try to get it made. That doesn't make you talented. It's whether or not it has a meaning to your story. And in some cases, the imagery that's depicted in the film and the brutality of it does. It's really just his use of the incredible narcissistic side to him that ruined entire portions of the film. I would say more worrisome than the violent aspects of the film would be a scene where Jack and Verge, these two inner monologues going on throughout the film, which, by the way, contains way too much exposition. There's a scene where they have a discussion about icons in history, and there's a lot of footage with Hitler. This is worrisome for a number of obvious reasons, but also due to comments that von Trier made at Cannes a few years back that actually got him banned for a year that were sympathetic towards Hitler. He later said he was joking, and that very well could be. Humor can be very dark and subversive sometimes, and I'm totally okay with that. Again, I must reiterate, if I tell you not to see the movie, it's not because it's violent or because it has this or that. It's just because I think he ruined his own film that was so brilliant for a large portion of it by shoving his egotistical side into the movie yet again just to get a reaction, because he wants that reaction. But he's become a reactionary filmmaker and not an artistic filmmaker. He's becoming a filmmaker that puts things in front of an audience and says, hey, what do you think of that? That's pretty fucked, right? His films are filled with so much brilliance, and then he has to insert these things to get people to talk, and he wants to get those mouths moving, and he wants that word of mouth, and he wants that fear about what you might be seeing, and then you watch it and you realize, well, that was some really gruesome stuff, yes, but what did it mean? What is he going for? Is he just a very angry person, or is he just want the world to feel as sad as he does? What is his goal with a movie like this? And it doesn't always work. There's so many aspects of it that I thought were just so good and so potentially wonderful. I can recommend the film to someone who likes some seriously dark shit, who is okay with some very vile imagery. But at the same time, it's a movie that gets so tedious and so long at 2.5 hours, and it has so many little sequences of analysis and dissertation about art and architecture and the way buildings are made, which does have an aspect of the plot for sure and feels like it belongs in the movie. But then there's this whole sequence that just feels like it doesn't belong in the movie that makes you wonder why. The ending, however, literally the ending, like the final shot, is one of my favorite von Trier endings ever. I think it's really, really good, and it's very interesting, and it'll get people talking, which all of his movies do, but I think the way the ending gets people talking is a good way of getting people talking. But there are things sprinkled throughout that it feel almost intentional to get some sort of reactionary response to maybe eventually get more people to see your movie, which I understand that being the goal, but in the end, I think a filmmaker should be more concerned with your film's passage through time, not the here and now. I'm going to give The House That Jack Built a B-. If I'm being honest with you, this is one of those times when I hate grading movies. I really hate grading movies like this. I wish I didn't have a grading system for movies like this, and it's entirely possible that in the future I might completely eliminate grades because I just don't feel right giving a film this subversive and strange a grade because it has so many brilliant moments, but then there are moments designed to make you hate it. Like the moments want you to hate it. And so it's hard to grade a film like that. And I challenge anyone who sees it to try. Go for it. Anyway, that's my review of this movie. Have a nice one, guys. Maybe see it if you like really fucked up shit that you can tolerate. If you can't handle some of those things, I wouldn't recommend it because it is a bleak film that does not hold back in any way, shape, or form. Nevertheless, guys, thank you so much as always for watching. And if you like this, you can click right here and get Stuckmanized.